Exposition of the Holy Quran by G. A. Harway, Surah 3, Al Imran, verse 151-200.
سنلقي في قلوب الذين كفروا الرعب بما أشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا ومأواهم النار وبئس مثوى الظالمين.
151 If you follow Allah's laws exclusively, you will be unafraid and courageous, but if you also obey anyone other than Allah, it will weaken your heart. Allah has not issued any authority for such obedience. Jahannam shall be your 12, 39, 18, 26, 18, 110, 39, 29, 42, 21. How vile is the dwelling place of Zialamin.
وَلَقَدْ صَدَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ إِذْ تَحُسُّونَهُمْ بِإِذْنِهِ حَتَّى إِذَا فَشِلْتُمْ وَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ وَعَصَيْتُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَرَاكُمْ مَا تُحِبُّونَ مِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرِيدُ الدُّنْيَا وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرِيدُ الْآخِرَةَ ثم صرفكم عنهم ليبتليكم ولقد عفا عنكم والله ذو فضل على المؤمنين.
152 Just one instance in the Battle of Uhud explains how much loss you suffer collectively when you have only the worldly gains before you. While you were destroying the enemy and gaining superiority over them, and thereby the divine promise was being fulfilled. The victory was in sight, but exactly at that time you faltered and started quarreling among yourselves about the order. The orders of your commander were ignored. Some of you were tempted to get immediate worldly gains, and others whose eyes were set on the future wanted to remain steadfast. Consequently, your attention was diverted from the enemy towards the booty and you were defeated. Your own worth became visible. However, when later on you realized your mistake and came back to the original position, you were once again victorious. This is the law of Allah. If someone falters or commits mistake, he is not deprived of the bounties for the rest of his life. Whenever he realizes the mistake and comes back to the straight path, he is entitled for all the divine bounties.
إِذْ تُصْعِدُونَ وَلَا تَلْوُونَ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ وَالرَّسُولُ يَدْعُوكُمْ فِي أُخْرَاكُمْ فَأَثَابَكُمْ غَمًّا بِغَمٍّ لِكَيْ لَا تَحْزَنُوا عَلَىٰ مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا مَا أَصَابَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ.
153 During this defeat, you were so much flabbergasted that you did not even look back to see in what condition your companions were.
Although your Rasul was calling you from the rear, you were thus suffering one loss after the other.
The lesson of the story is that you should never, on your own, leave the assigned job and run after something apparently getting out of hand. Never leave your position, even in extreme adversity. Remain steadfast, and Allah is aware of all what you do.
ثم أنزل عليكم من بعد الغم أمنة نعاسا يغشى طائفة منكم وطائفة قد أهمتهم أنفسهم يظنون بالله غير الحق ظن الجاهلية يقولون هل لنا من الأمر من شيء قل إن الأمر كله لله يخفون في أنفسهم ما لا يبدون لك يقولون لو كان لنا من الأمر شيء ما قتلنا هاهنا قل لو كنتم في بيوتكم لبرز الذين كتب عليهم القتل إلى مضاجعهم وليبتلي الله ما في صدوركم وليمحص ما في قلوبكم والله عليم بذات الصدور.
154 Recovery from the setback restored calmness to those who had a firm iman. As for the Munafiqeen, they indulged in pagan ignorance and untenable suspicion against Allah. They went so far as to say, "What is this? Why should the decision to wage a war be made by one person?
If we had a say in the matter, we would not have come here to be slain."
Tell them, O Rasul, these decisions are made according to Allah's laws. Even if you had not fought in this war, the Jamaat al-Mu'mineen would have come here and fought by itself. The good that came out of the behavior of the Munafiqeen was that it gave overt expression to what was hidden within them, for Allah is quite aware of what is in the hearts.
الذين تولوا منكم يوم التقى الجمعان إنما استزلهم الشيطان ببعض ما كسبوا ولقد عفى الله عنهم إن الله غفور حليم.
155 It was not the case that those who faltered had lost their iman.
Rather, they misjudged priorities. Once they regretted their actions and made good the loss, they were pardoned by Allah. Allah is forbearing.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين كفروا وقالوا لإخوانهم إذا ضربوا في الأرض أو كانوا غزا لو كانوا عندنا ما ماتوا وما قتلوا ليجعل الله ذلك حسرة في قلوبهم والله يحيي ويميت والله بما تعملون بصير ولئن قتلتم في سبيل الله أو متتم لمغفرة من الله ورحمة خير مما يجمعون ولئن متتم أو قتلتم لإلى الله تحشرون.
156-158 O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, be not like those who say about their brethren who had gone on a journey or engaged in battle. Had they stayed with us, they would not have died or been slain. Such a mentality makes one oblivious of the laws of life and death.
Those who fight for the truth and are slain or die in the struggle will receive a reward greater than all the treasures of the world.
Humanity's caravan is proceeding step by step towards its destination.
فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَانفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ.
159 O Rasul, one of the reasons for the progress of the Jamaat al-Mu'mineen is that you are soft-hearted. Had you been hard of heart, they would have broken away from you. Hence overlook their minor shortcomings and give them your protection. But soft-heartedness does not mean weak-heartedness. The Jamaat al-Mu'mineen are your companions. Consult them in matters relating to your system and when you have resolved on any course, Trusting in Allah's laws, you should go ahead and certainly Allah loves those who place their trust in His laws.
إن ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم وإن يخذلكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعده وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون.
160 This is the manner in which matters should be resolved.
As long as it is followed, none can overpower you. When you cease to follow it, none will be able to help you.
Therefore, O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, always have confidence in Allah's laws.
وَمَا كَانَ لِنَبِيٍّ أَن يَغُلَّ وَمَن يَغْلُلْ يَأْتِ بِمَا غَلَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ.
161 This confidence in Allah's laws can only come out of a firm conviction that these laws have been communicated truthfully. And there cannot be any sort of doubt in a law which is communicated through a Nabi. It is just not conceivable that a Nabi would deceive or play false. It was after him that his followers made interpolations in the revelation. But when the Quranic order is established, the true revelations would become apparent, and everyone shall be paid in full for whatever he has done, and none shall be wronged. And if someone escapes in this world, he will get it in the life hereafter, because life is a continuous process.
أَفَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ كَمَنْ بَاءَ بِسَخَطٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَمَأْوَاهُ جَهَنَّمُ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ هُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِندَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ.
162-163 Those who conform to Allah's plans cannot be placed on the same footing as those who do not. The latter's abode shall be hell, how vile a journey's end. The former shall have a very high rank in the estimation of Allah, who is aware of what they do. 6. 133-84-19
إن الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين.
164 Allah has been gracious indeed to the Mu'mineen when He raised from amongst their own people a Rasul who communicates His laws to them, purifies and develops their character and teaches them the book and its objectives. Hitherto, they were in a state of rank ignorance.
أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُم مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُم مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّى هَذَا قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنْفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ.
165 By such instruction and training, the Rasul prepares you, O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, for the establishment of the divine order. To attain this objective, you will confront opposition. In this opposition, sometimes you will face defeat and sometimes you will have success. O Rasul, they ask you, whence was that defeat?
Quote dot.
Tell them, it was brought on by your own selves.
Allah has devised laws.
Whoever adheres to them gains success. Whoever disregards them suffers a loss. The loss you suffered at Uhud was in accordance with Allah's laws.
وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ فَبِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَلِيَعْلَمَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
166 One good that came out of the defeat was that the Mu'mineen and the Munafiqeen became known.
وليعلم الذين نافقوا وقيل لهم تعالوا قاتلوا في سبيل الله أو ادفعوا قالوا لو نعلم قتالا لاتبعناكم هم للكفر يومئذ أقرب منهم للإيمان يقولون بأفواههم ما ليس في قلوبهم والله أعلم بما يكتمون.
167 When the Munafiqeen were asked, come with us and fight in the way of Allah and defend yourselves, they stole away. Now they say that they were not sure whether there would actually be a war and that if they had been sure that there would be a war they would certainly have accompanied them. The Munafiqeen are liars. They are closer to Kufa than to Iman. What they say is not what is in their hearts. Allah knows well what they conceal.
الذين قالوا لإخوانهم وقعدوا لو أطاعونا ما قتلوا قل فادرؤوا عن أنفسكم الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون فرحين بما آتاهم الله من فضله ويستبشرون بالذين لم يلحقوا بهم من خلفهم ألا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون.
168 to 170 They stayed away from the battlefield and said about those who fought, had they accepted our counsel, they would never have been slain. Tell them, if you are telling the truth, show me how can you evade death forever. Do not ever think that those who have been slain in the cause of Allah are dead. Say, alive are they with Allah. Well provided with sustenance, rejoicing in what Allah has bestowed upon them, and glad that because of their sacrifice, those who have been left behind are free of fear and anxiety.
يستبشرون بنعمة من الله وفضل وأن الله لا يضيع أجر المؤمنين الذين استجابوا لله والرسول من بعد ما أصابهم القرح للذين أحسنوا منهم واتقوا أجر عظيم.
171 to 172 They are filled with joy at the blessings bestowed upon them by Allah. They have seen that Allah's promise to reward the Mu'mineen has indeed been fulfilled.
These Mu'mineen are the ones who responded to the call of divine order even after reverses had befallen them.
Whoever adheres to Allah's laws receives an excellent reward.
الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
173 When these Mu'mineen were told that they should be wary of their enemy who had mustered great strength against them, it only strengthened their iman and they said, Sufficient unto us is Allah who is the most dependable.
فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم.
174 They returned with the bounties and blessings of Allah untouched by any harm. This was because they abided by Allah's laws whose munificence is great.
إنما ذلكم الشيطان يخوف أولياءه فلا تخافوهم وخافون إن كنتم مؤمنين.
175 Shaitan causes others to be afraid of his party. O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, you believe in Allah, therefore, you need not be afraid of his party.
ولا يحزنك الذين يسارعون في الكفر إنهم لن يضروا الله شيئا يريد الله ألا يجعل لهم حظا في الآخرة ولهم عذاب عظيم
176 O Rasul, let those people who hasten towards Kufr aggrieve you not. They can do no harm to Allah. By their tactics they may secure some paltry gains, but they will have no share in the hereafter. For them shall be great torment.
إن الذين اشتروا الكفر بالإيمان لن يضروا الله شيئا ولهم عذاب أليم ولا يحسبن الذين كفروا أنما نملي لهم خير لأنفسهم إنما نملي لهم ليزدادوا إثما ولهم عذاب مهين
177-178 Surely those who purchase kufra at the cost of iman shall not hurt Allah in any way and for them tremendous suffering awaits therein.
They should not think that the respite they have is profitable for them. If they do not mend their ways during this time, the respite will simply add to their torment and consequently their potentialities of development would get weak and for them is humiliating chastisement.
ما كان الله ليذر المؤمنين على ما أنتم عليه حتى يميز الخبيث من الطيب وما كان الله ليطلعكم على الغيب ولكن الله يجتبي من رسله من يشاء فآمنوا بالله ورسله وإن تؤمنوا وتتقوا فلكم أجر عظيم
179 During the initial phase of a movement, different types of people, including hypocrites, joined the movement and caused disruption. This state of affairs will not continue forever. Allah will surely sift the tayyab from kabis. He will not disclose to you who is a hypocrite and who is not.
He sometimes discloses to his Rasul what is kept in secret, but he will not do so with regards to the hypocrites.
47:29-30 Hence, O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, you should have complete trust in your order and adhere to Allah's laws. You will thus have a great reward.
ولا يحسبن الذين يبخلون بما آتاهم الله من فضله هو خيرا لهم بل هو شر لهم سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة ولله ميراث السماوات والأرض والله بما تعملون خبير
180 The fundamental purpose of this order is to provide nurture to all humanity. Those who can find the means of nurture to themselves should not imagine that this is good for them. Those who covetously withhold what Allah has given them shall find that when the Nizam-e-Rububiyat is established, these very things would become halter around their necks. They should know that everything in the universe belongs to Allah and none has the right to claim its ownership.
لقد سمع الله قول الذين قالوا إن الله فقير ونحن أغنياء سنكتب ما قالوا وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق ونقول ذوقوا عذاب الحريق ذلك بما قدمت أيديكم وأن الله ليس بظلام للعبيد
181-182 The system sometimes calls for contributions. Your opponents tauntingly say, "Your Allah is indigent and we are rich." We have heard and recorded what they say. We have also recorded that they have murdered some of their Anbiya against all the right. For all this they will face great torment, and it will be told to them that this is what they had prepared for themselves. Allah never does any zulm to his devotees.
الذين قالوا إن الله عهد إلينا ألا نؤمن لرسول حتى يأتينا بقربان تأكله النار قل قد جاءكم رسل من قبلي بالبينات وبالذي قلتم فلم قتلتموهم إن كنتم صادقين.
183 The Jews also say Allah has charged us not to believe in any claim to Nubuwwat until he brings us an offering which is consumed by the fire. O Rasul, tell them, many Rusul came before me with clear signs. According to you they also did what you now ask me to do, but instead of believing in him you tried to kill them. If your demand is made in earnest, then why did you treat your Anbiya thus?
فَإِن كَذَّبُوكَ فَقَدْ كُذِّبَ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ جَاءُوا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالزُّبُرِ وَالْكِتَابِ الْمُنِيرِ.
184 Anyhow they will continue discrediting you, O Rasul. You should not lose heart, for Rusul who came before you were equally discredited, although they came with clear arguments, scriptures and illuminating code of life.
كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور.
185 Tell them that worldly life is not eternal. Everyone shall taste death, and in the hereafter will be fully recompensed for his, her deeds. To be saved from Jahannam and led into Jannat will be a great achievement. To make worldly gains the sole objective of life is to cherish an illusion.
لَتُبْلَوُنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا وَإِنْ تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ.
186 O Jamaat al-Mu'mineen, you will continue to have confrontations with your opponents resulting in the loss of your possessions and your lives. 255 In addition you will also have to hear much from those who were granted revelation before your time and mushrikeen, which will be very painful to you. If you remain steadfast and adhere to Allah's laws it will reflect your high resolve.
وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ لَتُبَيِّنُنَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَكْتُمُونَهُ فَنَبَذُوهُ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ وَاشْتَرَوْا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَبِئْسَ مَا يَشْتَرُونَ.
187 The Al-Kitab say that Allah had charged them with such and such. This is not so. What Allah had charged them with was to expound what was given to them through revelation and not to conceal it. But they cast it behind their backs and fabricated their own shariat, bartering their revelation for a paltry price. What a bad transaction that was.
لا تحسبن الذين يفرحون بما أتوا ويحبون أن يحمدوا بما لم يفعلوا فلا تحسبنهم بمفازة من العذاب ولهم عذاب أليم ولله ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء قدير
188-189 Their religious leaders and priests rejoice over what they do. They love to be applauded for what they preach but do not practice. Here they will secure some paltry gain and the applause they seek, but in the hereafter they will face great torment. This proclamation is from Allah, who is supreme over all universe and has devised measures for all things.
إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار
190-191 In the creation of the earth and the heavens and the alternation of night and day, there are signs for those gifted with understanding. These people keep Allah's laws in mind whilst standing, sitting or reclining. After reflecting upon the creation of the heavens and the earth, they cry out, O our sustainer!
You have not created this universe in vain or for destructive purposes.
Your schemes of things are much above floor. Grant us the insight to understand the functioning of these things, so that we benefit from them and remain safe from suffering.
ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيته وما للظالمين من أنصار ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار
192-193 They also pray, O our sustainer! Grant that our efforts in this world are not wasted, for those whose efforts are rendered waste lead an ignoble life and these Zialamin have no helpers. Grant also that the forces of nature which we subdue are utilized for the benefit of humanity according to your laws. 13-17 We had heard the voice of a caller calling us to believe in you and we have believed. So, our sustainer,
if we falter, grant us protection and remove the ill effects of our deeds.
Grant us the companionship of those who have secured real freedom as a result of adhering to your laws.
O our sustainer,
grant us all that you have promised us through your Rasul and put us no to shame on the day of reckoning. We have a firm belief that you do not go back on your promises.
ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد فاستجاب لهم ربهم أني لا أضيع عمل عامل منكم من ذكر أو أنثى بعضكم من بعض فالذين هاجروا وأخرجوا من ديارهم وأوذوا في سبيلي وقاتلوا وقتلوا لأكفرن عنهم سيئاتهم ولأدخلنهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ثوابا من عند الله والله عنده حسن الثواب.
194-195 They thus supplicated their sustainer, and their sustainer hearkened to their prayers spontaneously, saying, "Certainly I will not suffer the labor of any one amongst you, man or woman, to be lost. The one of you is as the other. Those of you who have migrated or were driven out of their homes, those who have suffered in my cause and those who have fought and have fallen will be protected from the ill effects of their shortcomings and led into gardens through which streams flow. This is recompense from Allah, with whom lies the best recompense."
لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا قليل متاع ثم مأواهم جهنم وبئس المهاد.
196-197 Let not the prosperity of your opponents deceive you. It is only illusory and for a brief period. Then Jahannam shall be their abode, and what a wretched abode that shall be.
لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم جنة جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها نزلا من عند الله وما عند الله خير للأبرار.
198 But as to those who adhere to Allah's laws, for them are gardens through which streams flow, therein to abide.
A ready welcome from Allah. This reception will be the best for the truly virtuous ones.
وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ خَاشِعِينَ لِلَّهِ لَا يَشْتَرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا أُولَئِكَ لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ.
199 The Ahlul Kitab say that Jannat is reserved for them, but Allah's law of mukafat is that if they believe in Allah and in what has been sent down to you and in what had been sent down to them, and obey Allah's laws and do not barter Allah's commandments for a paltry price, they shall be recompensed adequately for the deeds. Allah is quick in measuring out recompense.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اصبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون.
200 O Jamaat al-Mu'minin, Allah's laws have reached you. Now you be steadfast yourself and cause others also to be steadfast, stand united and adhere to Allah's laws so that you may prosper.